and welcome to the Jacob Rader Marcus Center for the American Jewish Archives. My name is Dana Benson, and I'm a third-year rabbinical student on the Cincinnati campus of the Hebrew Union College. One of the unique opportunities afforded to me by being on this campus is the ability to do research at the Jacob Rader Marcus Center for the American Jewish Archives. The archives are committed to preserving a documentary heritage of the American Jewish experience. Part of its collection includes sheet music from the late 1800s and early 1900s. This collection provides a unique insight into the Jewish influence on the American Broadway musical. Today, Broadway musicals are reaching to a much larger audience through TV shows like Smash and Glee, and through hit movies such as Les Miserables and Rent. However, many people don't realize the significant influence that Jews had on the American Broadway musical.
There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low.
As we look into the music and lyrics of these composers, we can see how their Jewish experience helped them to form their songs and their early works. Many of these early songs of the Tin Pan Alley era speak directly to the Jewish American experience. Today, we will learn about one of those songs by Charles K. Harris.
A rabbi sat one evening with Bible on his knee.
Charles K. Harris was born in 1867 in New York. He spent his years growing up in Saginaw, Michigan, where his father moved the family due to his business as a fur trader. From an early age, Harris demonstrated an interest in music, specifically in banjo and in minstrel shows. At the age of 14, his family moved to Milwaukee, where he began to play minstrel songs on the banjo at small clubs. This is where he began composing his own music. Harris, as he later admitted in his autobiography, After the Ball, could not tell one note from another. His inability to read music was of no obstacle to him, though, as he would hire trained musicians to write down the melodies that he would hum to them. In 1891, Harris started his own publishing house, a move that would make him the only printer-publisher-composer in America. Just a year later, Harris again would make history. His song, After the Ball, became the first popular song to sell several million copies of sheet music.
Hello, friends. You know, it seems only yesterday that I wrote that old time song of mine, both words and music, of After the Ball. You know, I have a great fondness for that old song, which I composed way back in 1892. Why are you single? Why live alone? Have you no baby? Have you no home?
After this, Harris continued to compose many popular songs, including The Rabbi's Daughter. In the song, A Rabbi's Daughter, the lyrics tell of an issue that faced many Jews as they assimilated into American culture, dating and marrying non-Jews. In this story song, we hear a tale of a girl who has fallen in love with someone who is not Jewish. However, she is the rabbi's daughter, and her father disapproves of her love. At first, as we hear in the chorus, this song seems to condemn interfaith marriage. You are a rabbi's daughter, and as such you must obey. Your father you must honor unto his dying day. If you a Christian marry, your old father's heart you'll break. You are a rabbi's daughter, and must leave him for my sake. In these lyrics, we hear a common theme from both that era and of our own. The heartbreak of a parent if their child chooses to marry outside of Judaism. As the song comes to a close, we hear of how the daughter dies due to heartbreak. Here is where Harris seemingly presents his own views, that there are consequences if we hold strictly to endogamy, or marrying within one's own social or ethnic class. Harris presents it as a physical death. However, there were many Jewish families that were estranged by intermarriage, causing a sense of emotional death between family members.
A rabbi sat one evening with Bible on his knee. His daughter knelt beside him, for she loved him tenderly. "Come tell me, child," the rabbi said, "why do you weep and sigh? Don't be afraid to trust me, dear. Tell me the reason why. You are a rabbi's daughter and must leave him for my sake."
Although this song was not the most popular of Harris's works, it was well received. The sad song was hyped as the world's greatest song, and the New York Clipper in 1900 claimed it was the only song of its kind ever written. This beautiful, sentimental song is creating a furor wherever sung. This praise speaks to the song's popularity, both among Jews as well as for non-Jews who may have felt similar struggles of dating within their social class. Through music, Harris is able to bring to light, for Jewish and non-Jewish audiences alike, the possible consequences of endogamy. I now invite you to listen to the song and analyze it for yourself. As you listen to the words and music, hear how Harris has woven the story together, as well as how he presents the struggle of interfaith marriage, a struggle that continues more than 100 years later.
"I must not love you, dear. I ne'er must see your faith, and that you cannot marry me. For you're not of my faith, but I shall have no other love. And though my heart should break, would you, my love, all faithful be, though I may never wake?" Your words came true that very morn, for on her bed so white, I found his only child had died for love that night. "You are a rabbi's daughter, and as such you must obey. Your father you must honor unto his dying day. If you a Christian marry, your old father's heart you'll break. You are a rabbi's daughter, and must leave him for my sake."
Thank you so much for listening. I hope that listening to this song, A Rabbi's Daughter by Charles K. Harris, has provided you with a unique insight into the American Jewish experience. And now I'd like to take a moment to thank all of those people who have helped me and supported me on this project.
Alke ledem rebens, sich gerocken inner wie mit Zeichel. Tirata jeden Ort geht, am ist das von Karriere nicht. Alke ledem rebens, das ist sie.